Good morning, Al. So today we are going to discuss about the hand-operated hydraulic jacks, which comes under the Pascal's law, the application of the Pascal's law, which comes in the fluid power system. So in this hand-operated hydraulic jack, so we have the two cylinders. One cylinder is called the pump cylinder, and one more is called the load cylinder. So this pump cylinder piston, we have attached it to the one handle, that is the intense of the A, B, C, three points. And afterwards, we have the two check valves here, check valve 1 and the check valve 2. So along with that, we are using the bleed valve, and we have the reservoir, and we have the load cylinder. So the two cylinders are using, one is the smaller side, one is the bigger cylinder. So how it going to be works? So here, there is a two, three point, as far as A, B, C. So here, at the seat has been pinned over here, and here, at the rod of the pump cylinder will be attached to the handle over here. So when you are going to lift this one, so what happens, let's say, the piston of the pump cylinder, comes up. So during that time, the vacuum will be created at over here. Because of that time, it will be sucks the fluid from the reservoir. So the atmosphere pressure of the fluid will push the piston to the reservoir, it will come to the this one. So when I am going to be come out here, so through the check valve, the function of the check valve is to allow the fluid to travel in one direction, and it will not allow the fluid to go back. And now the oil has been sucked over there, it has been accumulated over here. So when I am going to push the anchor to the pump side, so what happens over here, in the sense, the oil will be pushed over here. So here there is no option to go out. So the oil has to go to the check valve too. So here the check valve will get open, and going to be accumulated at the bottom of the load cylinder. So here what happens, at each time when I go to be applying the up and the down, so what happens, the fluid will be continuously coming over here, and it will be accumulated here. So then what happens, so the pressure of the fluid will push the load cylinder to move the load to the upper side. So the bleed valve will be seen here. So when I want to lower, once it has been completed, when I want to lower the load over here, so I'll be using the bleed valve. When I get opened over here, the fluid will be coming back to the tank, so that the load will be lowered.